Hey there and welcome! In this video, I will go over some complications and lessons learned while programming the game of life in Unity. The code is included in the description. Long story short, this is what I ended up with. So how did I get to this point? Before we start, you should know that Unity and C# are not part of my regular toolchain. However, I have played around with them in the past. Recently, I decided I needed a refresher and that Conway's Game of Life would be a good candidate for a quick one-day project. The game itself requires no input at all, and all you do is observe how virtual cells evolve over time. Given a random starting configuration and a set of very limited rules, most cells will then quickly die off, while others become self-sustaining structures, oscillators, and so-called spaceships. With some luck, you get some awesome patterns and behaviors to look at. So, having all of this in mind, I was ready to get started on a lazy Sunday afternoon. And it did not take long until my initial excitement for this task crumbled into pieces. Not only had I forgotten each and every best practice, naming convention, workflow and more, I also somehow managed to consistently shoot myself into the foot. Watch me here typing furiously while trying to remember my shortcuts. I won't go through any code in this video, but instead speak about some things I should remember next time. Lesson number one, start small. With this I mean, I should not have started by adding hundreds of objects, and I truly mean hundreds, to have something to look at in the scene view. For some reason, I thought that I would figure out everything while adding cubes. In reality, I just started questioning myself. After realizing my mistake, I was convinced that this would end badly. As a result, I backtracked and reduced the size of my playing field to first get the basic rules working. Once this was done, I then dynamically generated a larger playing field from within my code. Lesson number two, know your basics. In my case, an early roadblock was that I needed to find a way to perform a calculation every second. Unfortunately, I could not remember the corresponding function for the life of me. In other words, I got stuck the very moment I wanted to write my first line of code. This annoyed me as it meant I had to look up a bunch of basics before getting back into the fun stuff. I also saw the writing on the wall that this would take more than one afternoon. In the future, I really should try to brush up my knowledge before jumping right into it, and I hope that this will then help me avoid losing my motivation and staying more focused. Number 3. I am not a 3D developer. Coordinates, rotations, vectors, and my absolute favorite, quaternions, are not my friends. Watch me here, launching the game after trying to rotate the camera around the world. I did not look up any help at this point, and I believe the footage speaks for itself. As a matter of fact, having the field of view spin around the playing field took me way longer than I'm comfortable to admit, especially knowing that I have done the very same thing in the previous project. And yes, it still does not completely behave as I wanted. I don't know what the lesson is, so let's jump to the last part. Lesson number 4. Bad performance. So the longer I worked on the project, the worse the performance became. It did not help that I nested loops as if CPU cycles were currently on sale. Furthermore, I had decided to check the material of a cell to know if a cell is alive or not, which turned out to be a major slowdown. Doing all of this, I was fully aware that my looping strategy was sketchy at best, but I was too proud to look at any reference implementations. And sadly, I was too tired at this point to think of any improvements myself. However, after experimenting a bit with more efficiently reading cell states, I was able to get everything running smoothly enough for me to finally push this project over the finish line. Next time, I really should avoid reinventing the wheel. To conclude, what did we learn? Well, I like criticizing my development decisions. And if nothing else, this little project frustrated me just enough to make an entire video out of it, and to get me started on something else. I also hope that you got some amusement out of it. We'll see how the next project goes. I thank you for watching.